Thank you so much. It's really wonderful to be here. My first time in Louisiana, and I enjoyed the beautiful weather yesterday and the almost drowning weather today. But I've been inside all day, so it didn't really matter. That's the good thing with the organ, is it's a rain or shine thing. So I just played one of the most famous French toccatas, and it showcases the fiery reeds on this organ. And now I'm going to play a Prelude and Fugue by Bach. This is one of his earlier pieces. It showcased his virtuosity as an organist. You'll see a lot of solo pedal parts where I don't play anything with my hands. And that is typical of this phase of his writing. And the fugue is just one of the most ebullient and dance-like fugues, where the subject feels like you want to just bob right along with it. So enjoy the Prelude and Fugue in A minor. Now I'm going to play something very different. These are folk songs from Taiwan. And Taiwan is, of course, a very small island off the coast of China. And it's where my father's family is from. And I had the privilege of living there for 1 year after college. And I grew up speaking Mandarin with my grandmother, and she would sing in Taiwanese some of these songs to me as a child. And years later, I heard a recording of folk songs arranged for symphony orchestra, and I thought this would sound really great on the organ. And so that's how this first piece was written, Taiwanese Suite.
Thank you.
going to close the first half with another piece by a French composer, and this piece is one of the most wonderful works for organ and very different than everything we've heard so far. It starts off almost inaudibly, like, where is this sound bubbling up from? It's so quiet, but it's fast. It's like a little bit of running water, and you'll hear these very enchanting melodies that are played in kind of the high-pitched area. And that prelude is just mostly in this piano, mezzo-piano range, very soft, very lyrical. And it ends in almost a meditative fashion, because this piece was written in honor of Duruflé's friend, Jean Alain, a composer who died in the French army in World War II. And this composer, Jean Alain, had written a very famous organ piece called Litanies, and many organists still play it. It's a wonderful piece. It has this very catchy melody, and Duruflé quotes the entire melody at the end of the prelude, so in homage to his friend. But it's in such a different context, it's almost hard to know how it completely relates to Alain's piece. Then you'll hear the fugue, and where it says prelude and fugue on A-L-A-I-N, the name, Alain, he transliterated those letters of Alain's name into the pitches the musical pitches. And of course, if you know in music, we really only have A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So what do you do with the next letters? Well, you start back, and H is one of these strange ones, but basically, take that one out, but basically it goes from there, I goes back to A, and then J becomes B and K, and this is how he created the other notes out of the letters of Alain's name, and that is quoted in the first five notes of the fugue. And this fugue is just a robust, beautiful, slow, but then builds up into this incredible, almost like a resurrection at the end. So it's a beautiful homage to his friend Jean Alain, and I hope you enjoy it. start the second half with a piece by a Norwegian composer. His name is Ola Gjeilo, and he is very well known right now for his choral music as well as some film scoring, and this is to date his only piece for the organ, but I was lucky enough to do the premiere back at Juilliard because he was one of my classmates, and he had written this piece for his girlfriend, but then they broke up and she never played it. So that's how I ended up with it. And Sinfonietta means a little symphony, so it's in about 7 minutes, and it really has like a beginning and a middle and then an epic finale.
Thank you.
Now we're going to hear a piece by the Czech composer Petr Eben, and this is probably his most famous composition, and it's called Moto, Ostinato, because the word ostinato, it describes a rhythmic pattern. It's like bump, 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 and when you hear it over and over, and every single bar is the same pattern, you will start to feel like, wow, there's this, it's almost hypnotic, except that in this piece, he has lots of variations, so there are moments when it's very present, and other times it's very soft, so the variations go into different areas. And Eben was a composer who also lived through World War II and post-World War II in very difficult times in the Soviet Union, and he was persecuted a lot for what he was trying to do in his music, and we're lucky that we have this incredible piece. It's almost like a battle between darkness and light, and it's quite fiery at the end, where I get to jump from keyboard to keyboard, which you can see on this brilliant screen. So hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
The last two pieces are back in the French tradition. The first is a shorter piece by Vierne called Naïades, and that is an impressionistic piece depicting water nymphs kind of bouncing along in the waves. So you'll hear all kinds of scales in either the right hand or the left hand. It's kind of like an etude for this entire time, and then the other hand plays either a melody or the bopping nymphs in the water. And then the last piece is an excerpt from the Saint-Saëns Organ Symphony, which is probably the most beloved piece for organ and orchestra. But usually the organist doesn't play, I mean, you normally sit and wait for your big entrance about 24 minutes into the piece. And you do play a little bit earlier, but it's very soft. At this point, there's a big C major chord, and from there to the end, it's about 8 minutes of a lot of chords usually in the organ in the organ part, but in this solo transcription, I get to play all the fun bits that the orchestra plays, the string parts and the wind and brass. So it's a fabulous solo transcription of the whole last section of the symphony.